and welcome to this episode of Flyby, presented by the National Model Aviation Museum. I'm your host, Claire, and today I'll be discussing the most iconic trophy in air modeling history, the Mulvihill. Every year, the Nationals take place right here at the International Air Modeling Center in Muncie, Indiana. The National Air Modeling Championships, commonly referred to as the NATS, is defined as the one or more annual model aircraft competitions conducted by or sanctioned by the National Aeronautic Association or the Academy of Model Aeronautics for the purpose of determining the champion or champions in each category of member contestant and in each approved event. Initially, in 1923, there was only one event, the Mulvihill Trophy event, while over the years, many more events have been added to the competition, encompassing several weeks and a handful of locations every summer, the Mulvihill remains an important and coveted perpetual trophy for rubber-powered free flight modelers. When you visit the National Model Aviation Museum, you may notice a large number of trophies on display here. These are perpetual trophies, meaning they are still awarded every year to the best competitor in each event. After the winner's name is emblazoned on the trophy, it is returned to the exhibit case until the following year. The Mulvihill in particular is one of the most important NATS trophies because it not only was the very first one, but it also has a fascinating history. Prior to the 1923 NATS, Bernard H. Mulvihill, vice president of the newly incorporated National Aeronautic Association, decided to establish a national model airplane event. Many modelers had been clamoring for a national competition for years, and Mulvihill saw the 1923 St. Louis Air Races as the perfect occasion to introduce the event. He announced a sculpture contest to promote the design of a model aircraft trophy for the new contest, open to any student at an accredited art school with a specialization in sculpture. The three best designs were to be awarded cash prizes totaling over $150, with the judging taking place at the headquarters of the National Aeronautic Association in late summer. Initially, the design that gained the most popularity and publicity was not what we recognize today as the Mulvihill at all, but a design depicting a young boy holding a model airplane. However, that particular design, along with the identity of the winning artist, have both been lost. The Mulvihill trophy we recognize today depicts Icarus, a figure from Greek mythology. The story of Icarus is a familiar one. In an attempt to escape from imprisonment on the island of Crete, Icarus was overconfident and flew too close to the sun, which resulted in his plummet into the sea. The casting of Icarus for a flying trophy reminds us not to be too arrogant in our abilities as aero modelers. Now back to 1923, the singular event in the Nationals that year was the outdoor rubber-powered contest. In addition to winning the Mulvihill, there were cash prizes totaling $300. The winner was Edward G. Lange, a 16-year-old from Chicago, who won with a 4-minute, 22.6-second flight with his twin pusher. His name is clearly engraved on the base of the Mulvihill and can be seen alongside all the subsequent winners of the rubber-powered contest, which is still held today. Thank you for tuning in to this episode of Flyby. As always, please leave your questions, ideas, and suggestions in the comments section. Follow us on social media for updates on current projects, new donations, and behind-the-scenes historical air modeling information. We always appreciate your feedback. If you notice any discrepancies in the information provided or you have additional information, please email us at museum@modelaircraft.org.